and rose with him in new life, may she now share with him the eternal glory. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. May Christ, who was crucified for your sake, free you from torments. May Christ, who died for you, deliver you from eternal death. May Christ, the Son of the living God, set you down in the fresh beauty of his paradise.
May he, the good shepherd, claim you, Ethel, as one of his flock. May he grant you a place among the elect at his own right hand. There may you ever behold your Redeemer face to face, and ever stand before him placed in the ranks of the blessed. May you delight in the vision of God forever and ever. And our response at this time, I breathe forth my spirit to you, my Creator. I breathe forth my spirit to you, my Creator. Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord, Lord, hear my voice. O let your ears be attentive to the voice of my pleading. I breathe forth my spirit to you, my Creator. My soul is waiting for the Lord, I count on his word. My soul is longing for the Lord, more than watchman for daybreak. I breathe forth my spirit to you, my Creator. Because with the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. I breathe forth my spirit to you, my Creator. And now two very important symbols will be placed on the coffin. I will place the Bible. In life, Sister Ethel cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet her with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. And I our second symbol, the crucifix. In baptism, Sister Ethel received the sign of the cross. We pray as family, friends, community, may she now share in Christ's victory over death. My brothers and sisters, we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. And while we mourn for the loss of Sister Ethel, we trust in Christ, our risen Savior. Lord God, you are attentive to the voice of our pleading. Let us find in your Son comfort in our sadness, certainty in our doubt, and courage to live through this hour. Make our faith strong through Christ our Lord. And now the priest will retire to the sacristy, and we will process with the opening hymn in a few minutes' time. And to make this truly a celebration of Sister Ethel's life, I invite you to join in the singing of the hymns with those who are leading the music here today and the singing, because many of the hymns are very familiar to you. So let us make this a celebration of a wonderful life.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and
Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Warmest welcome to Bishop Willie Walsh, to Fathers Joe Horrigan, Donna O'Mara, Pat Sexton, Artie Kelly, Paddy Conway, John Malai, And to all who have joined us in prayer on our parish webcam, 100 FM radio, and as we gather here in our Lady of the Wayside Church, Lisikesi, we do so to say a farewell to a wonderful and a most extraordinary woman in Sister Ethel Normal. And in particular at this time, our thoughts are very much with her family in their love for Ethel. Her dear sisters and her brother, Maura, Claire, Geraldine and Jerome, and all your family members, her many nieces and nephews, her grandnieces and grandnephews, some of you watching this Mass on the webcam from many parts of the world, Ethel's sister-in-law, Monica, and her many friends in her community in Missionvale, and among her own community of the Little Company of Mary Sisters. Our thoughts and our prayers are very much with all of you at this time. It is a testimony of a life truly lived in the service of others that the funeral mass of an unassuming Sister Ethel has garnered such widespread sympathy and affection at her passing. She is widely acknowledged for her outstanding legacy, a legacy of goodness and ministry to her community and among the many people in Missionvale whom she worked with and dearly loved. Sister Ethel was always the heartbeat of her community, someone as very precious, as remarked by Queen Elizabeth after her visit to Sister Ethel, where she said these words, how the inspiration and the energy of one person can benefit thousands of people. She said it is volunteers like Sister Ethel who spread that message, and it is for the rest of us to welcome it. In prayer we pause. Lord Jesus, you are the source of light and goodness, Lord have mercy. Christ Jesus, you are our inspiration and hope, Christ have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, our hope of resurrection, Lord have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith as a community here this afternoon professes that Jesus Christ died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through these sacred mysteries, Sister Ethel, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Now I warmly invite Sisters Mary Flanagan and Patricia Duggan to present our readings from the Book of Wisdom and the Letter to the Romans. We will hear in the first reading how the souls of the virtuous have proven themselves worthy to be with their God. And we hear a lovely word in the second reading, the word influence. Sister Ethel, in the course of her very fruitful life, had a very positive influence on many people's lives.
First reading, a reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster, but they are at peace. If they experienced suffering as we see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction, great will their blessings be. God has put them to the test and proven them worthy to be with him. When the time comes for his visitation, they will shine out as sparks through the stubble, so will they. They who trust in him will understand the truth, for grace and mercy await those he has chosen. The word of the Lord.
I will be the vine, and you will be the branches, all you who live in me will never, never die. I will be the sign, I will offer many chances, so live, oh live in me, and you shall have new life. Remain in me, as I remain in you. You may ask what you will, ask what you will, and you shall receive. I will be the vine, and you
of us has its influence on others. If we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So that alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. This explains why Christ both died and came to life. It was so that he might be both Lord of the dead and of the living. We shall all have to stand before the judgment seat of God. As scripture says, by my life, it is the Lord who speaks. Every knee shall bend before me, every tongue shall praise God. It is to God, therefore, that each of us must give account of our sins. This is the word of the Lord.
Life, you have the message of eternal life.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. I was hungry, and you fed me. Thirsty, and you gave me a drink. I was a stranger, and you received me into your home. Naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you took care of me. In prison, and you visited me. The righteous will then answer him, "When, Lord, did we ever see you hungry and feed you? Are thirsty and give you drink? When did we ever see you a stranger and welcome you in our homes, or naked and clothe you? When did we ever see you sick or in prison and visit you?" And the Lord will reply, "I tell you, whenever you did this for one of the least important members of my family, you did it for me." Gospel of the Lord. Those very familiar words, "I am the vine, you are the branches," beautifully sung for the responsorial psalm this afternoon. And those words, "It is to the glory of God that you should bear much fruit." And we know that for fruit to become bountiful and nourishing, it needs to be connected to the tree, the source that feeds it and continually nourishes it. And likewise, our human hearts, and especially our human spirit, also need to rest in God to enable us to achieve far more than we could ever imagine in life. And that's why I love that prayer from the Divine Word missionaries in Roscommon, which reminds us that the human heart is a great tree. And you see in front of your funeral booklet this afternoon the picture of a tree. And I'm told it's 180 years old. And those are the words of Sister Ethel. But that prayer, "The human heart is a great tree, and when we hang there gifts for others, we hang up also gifts of happiness for ourselves." Those who bring sunshine into the lives of others, the prayer goes, cannot keep it from themselves. It is what we do for others that we think of most pleasantly. "For I was hungry," as the gospel tells us today, "and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was sick, and you visited me. I was a stranger, and you made me welcome." And as Sister Ethel initially had only a tree to teach those in her care, little did she imagine that over a lifetime of love and service to others, those branches would bear bountiful fruits for tens of thousands of people in her care. These people, she said, simply had very little. They lived, many of them, in dire poverty. Employment was non-existent. Education was very scarce. Alcoholism and crime were serious problems in the community, ravaged by disease. So establishing the Mission Vale Care Center, establishing that center bore the fruit of hope for many, many people who came every single day for food, for clothing, for life-saving medicine, for education, and for the loving care of the community in Mission Vale and Sister Ethel in her own inimitable way, because she had that warmth and that presence. And any of you who've ever been in her company, there was something about when you walked away, you always felt much the better for meeting her. She had something very precious within her. And that gave the many people who visited Mission Vale an abundance of love and care and welcome. And so many people in life need those things. We all need those things in life. And that reminds me of the words of St. Paul: work for the Lord with untiring effort and with great earnestness of spirit, having a profound respect and love for those in your care. And like the many disciples on their missionary journeys, bringing their enduring faith and love of the Lord to the people in their care, Sister Ethel brought her own outstanding legacy of goodness and ministry to her community. And among the people she walked with, worked for, and more importantly, dearly loved over many, many years. Ethel was the heartbeat of her community, ably supported by her many friends and her many companions on her journey, supported by many volunteers and indeed students who visited her in Mission Vale, and indeed her generous benefactors. There was a whole circle of people. She really appreciated their support and their presence, and anything they could do was much appreciated by her, because as the gospel says, it gave life to so many people in her care and the care of the community in Mission Vale. In her own words, and I love these words, "My goal in life is to make God's glory praised and to bring Christ's compassion to the people through practical means." For family, her community, her friends were always in your love. And many times a message would come back, and occasionally I would mention that from the altar, how the people of Lissy Casey and her dear family were very, very precious to her among her friends. And these are her words: "It's hard to express the love I have for Lissy Casey. Personally, in her company, I will always treasure the gentleness and the warmth of her personality." Again, something I'm sure all of you here today could easily identify with: the warmth of her personality and her good humor. And thinking of Ethel, I am reminded of the words of George Bernard Shaw: "Life to me is no brief candle. It is a sort of splendid torch which I have got hold of for the moment, and I want to make it burn as brightly as possible before handing it on to future generations." May the light of heaven shine on you, Ethel, and may you rest in the warmth of the embrace of your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We have many prayers, no doubt, in fond remembrance of Sister Ethel. And to present the prayers of the faithful, I warmly welcome Sister Bridget Finucane, Colleen, Pamela, Emer, Oisin, Shane and Grania to the Ambo now to present our prayers.
We pray for the Church. May the Holy Spirit lead and guide Pope Francis and all Church leaders. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We remember Sister Ethel's parents, Vera and John Normile, her brothers, Val and Kieran, her brother-in-law, Tom. May they all be united in heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord.
Lord, bless all Ethel's family who are here with us. Bless Monica, her sister-in-law, the many nieces and nephews, grandnieces and grandnephews who cannot be present. Lord, hear us.
May the life and work of the Little Company of Mary Sisters be rewarded as they keep the vision of Mother Mary Potter alive all over the world. Lord, hear us.
May the Lord bless and reward each member of staff in Milford Hospice for their dedicated care and kindness to Ethel during our time there. Lord, hear us. Bless abundantly the people of Mission Bell and all those associated with promotion of this mission. Lord, hear us.
Ethel strove to improve the quality of life for many. May we find the generosity of heart to do likewise. Lord, hear us.
And for the unspoken prayers deep within your own hearts, we pause for a moment. Lord, hear us. Lord Jesus, you are the vine, we are the branches. Like Sister Ethel, may we bear good fruit to the glory of God and the good of humanity. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Your healing blood.
my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. And as we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of Sister Ethel Normile, we beseech your divine mercy that she who did not doubt Jesus Christ to be her Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those who are saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful people, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and saints, we acclaim you now as we pray. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts that we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
He is Lord, he is Lord, he is risen from the dead, and he is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is.
Therefore, O Lord, as we as a community celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, Jesus Christ, his wondrous resurrection and his ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice.
Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the glorious martyrs and the founder of Sister Ethel's order, Sister Mary Potter, and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim people on earth, your servant Pope Francis, or Bishop Vinton, Bishop Willie, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Remember your servant Ethel, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when every tear will be wiped away from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. As a community of faith, as brothers and sisters precious to the Lord, and that's what we are, as members of his family, we pray now in the words that our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. We pray, Lord, deliver us from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. May this mending of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
Only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us all safe for eternal life.
I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulder. You raise me up to more than I can be. There is no life without its hunger. Each restless heart beats so imperfectly. But when you come and sometimes I think I glimpsed eternity. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulder. I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall not hunger. He who believes in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father draweth him, and I will raise him.
With a communion reflection at this time, followed by Cathal, who will address us for a few moments.
To those I love and to those who love me, my last breath did not say goodbye, for my love for you is truly timeless, beyond the touch of death. I leave myself in your memory with love. I leave my thoughts, my laughter, my dreams to you, whom I have treasured beyond gold and precious gems. I give you the memories of our times together, the tender, love-filled moments, the successes we have shared, the hard times that brought us closer together, and the roads we traveled side by side. I also leave you a solemn promise that after I am home with God, I will still be present whenever and wherever you call on me. Whenever you are in need, call me. I will come to you with my arms full of wisdom and light to be your avenue to God. And all I take with me as I leave is your love and the memories of all we have shared. Fear not my departure, you whom I have loved so much, for my roots and yours are forever entwined.
No words can fully describe Ethel. No story for what she has done for others can fully describe Ethel. The full extent of the work she has done will never be known. Her presence in the family home cannot be described. The people that have had the privilege of knowing and meeting Ethel have left feeling they have met a saint. Her warm heart and gentle words made her someone you were drawn to when you needed a friendly ear. We have received many messages, texts, and emails in the past few weeks and recent days, all lovely stories of their encounter with Ethel, and they all have the same to say, that I truly met someone special. Lissy Casey has always been very close to Ethel's heart, and the people of Lissy Casey have always been very good to Ethel. She has had many visits from here and surrounding areas from people who put their shoulder to the wheel and did what they could to help out with Ethel's projects. Ethel was forever grateful and thankful, and it would be very important for me on her behalf to sincerely thank everybody for their help. I would like to thank the little company of Mary, led by Sister Bernadette in Australia, for the effort in getting Ethel home. Particularly Sister Mary Flanagan in Ireland, Sister Patricia Duggan, who went to South Africa to accompany Ethel home, and Sister Bridget Finucane in Midford for overseeing her care. Ethel entered the convent in Midford House in Limerick, which is now synonymous with the compassionate, professional care the sisters and the staff give to those who are terminally ill. And I want to thank the medical team in Midford for their outstanding care of Ethel during her illness. I'd like to thank the people throughout the world for their prayers and comforting words during this time. Thanks to Father Brendan, Father Joe for their moving tribute to Ethel, to Bishop Willie, and all the priests who have honoured Ethel by their presence here today. And a very special thank you to the people of Missionvale and the amazing staff of Missionvale Care Centre who have supported and loved Ethel no end, and to the people who will continue to build upon Ethel's legacy in Missionvale. Today is a celebration of Ethel's amazing and unique life, and I'd like to thank Ethel for letting us all be part of that wonderful life. In conclusion, this is a poem of work that Ethel would often say that carried her through, and it goes like this. Love that is hoarded molds at last, until we know someday, the only love we ever have is what we give away. And as Ethel would say, God bless.
And for Cahill for those lovely personal words. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Let us pray, Lord God, whose Son Jesus Christ left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it Sister Ethel Normile may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And the Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. And now we come to the final commendation and farewell, and I invite you to stand. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of Sister Ethel. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. And our response at this time, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid, come to meet her. Angels of the Lord, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you Ethel, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Give her eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on her forever. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we as a community commend Sister Ethel Normile, in the sure and the certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the many blessings which you bestowed upon Ethel in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ Jesus. Merciful Lord, turn towards us, listen to our prayers, open the gates of paradise to your servant Ethel, and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurance of our faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. In peace, let us take Sister Ethel to her place of rest, and may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, where Lazarus is poor no longer. May you find eternal rest. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Even though the rain hides the stars,